describing him, maybe that's, maybe that's why people ask the question. He said that he pushed for you to fight Manny Pacquiao.
I don't know what's going on. Last time I heard about Floyd, he's fighting a guy.
In Japan.
Yeah. So I really don't know what's going on.
What do you think about that?
I'm really not focused on it. You know, more power to him. I know he's going to be, you know, successful. I know he's going to win. And, you know, he's going to make a lot of money. And I'm proud of him, you know. Ain't no hate in my blood, you know. I'm just focused on me.
You guys got that big bro, little bro thing going on. Sometimes you have your...
You tripping with the black dress.
You know, Adrien, you've been wanting to be on this stage for a long time in terms of having a pay-per-view. You know, what are some of your emotions, at the mind state of finally being here and getting that chance to finally be at this stage?
It's like she, they give me this chance. I gotta make the best out of it. I gotta take it. Cause I seen what can happen to fighters. You know, I know the ins and outs. You know, I probably say some crazy things, and I probably say some things that make me sound not too intelligent, but I'm one of the intelligent ones, and I know what's going on. So, you know, I'm gonna get this victory, and I gotta get this victory.
What's the key to victory here?
Fighting for like a sandwich. Go into more detail about that. Like, why do you feel that?
What'd you say?
You said yesterday at the press conference in New York that you feel like a bum fighting for a sandwich when you're up there on stage. What'd you mean by that?
I'm hungry. I need this motherfucking sandwich. Trying to eat.
Adrien, will you be sparring with Gervonta or Southpaw and, you know, Young Fast, all that?
What happens in training camp stays in training camp. You know, just know I'll be ready.
I mean, that's a big, I would think that's a big advantage for you, having kind of young, someone young, fast, Southpaw like that in camp with you.
What happens in training camp stays in training camp.
We got Gervonta over here. Can you kind of talk a bit about your relationship with him? Because you guys seem to have a lot of banter on Instagram together.
I mean, you know, two guys come from the same background, you know, and just want the best for each other, you know, and we push each other to be the best, you know, that's all it is.
Can you elaborate more on your journey? You come from the streets of Cincinnati, as your promoter said, and now you're fighting on pay-per-view against quote-unquote fighter of the decade. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say quote-unquote, but fighter of the decade.
It's just a dream come true, you know, and I'm just here to show the younger talent, the younger guys in Cincinnati and around the world that come from poverty and the type of places I come up, you know, that just follow your dream and work hard and you can make it too.
What's the toughest battle you've had in life?
The toughest battle I had in life?
Sure.
I tried surfing once.
On land. Huh. Hardest, toughest battle on land.
Oh, on land? Honestly?
Yes.
I can't say.
Okay. This is not the second half of your career, but you're 29. What impression do you want to leave on boxing? Because the next stage is obviously 100% promotion, encouraging the kids in Cincinnati. What's...
I just want to leave the boxing world entertained. And I just want to be the best Adrien Broner I could be. You know, and when they bring up Adrien Broner, you know, it always bring a smile to somebody's face and make somebody day better. And, you know, they can learn from me.
Go ahead, Michelle. Ladies first.
We've seen Manny Pacquiao be knocked out before. Do you feel that you can do the same, Jay?
Of course. He's been knocked out before, and there's no mystery he'll go to sleep again.
There are a slew of great 147-pounders that are undefeated, and you will be the first 147-pound outside of Floyd Mayweather. What's the secret to becoming a pay-per-view star in this market? Well, Terrence Crawford, but it didn't do well. I'm sorry.
It's more than just being a boxer. You have to be a entertainer. You know, it's entertainment, and you just gotta make people want to watch you, no matter if they want to see you lose or want to see you win. And I think I kind of got that down back.
And I'll touch on that a little bit. Adrien is just a natural showman. He's the perfect fit for the pay-per-view model. That's why the sky's the limit. I think that with him having this opportunity, this is what excites him the most. He saw a guy like Floyd rise to the level and make tons and tons of money with just going out there and winning big, big fights on the right kind of platform. And this is a great opportunity for him. And I think that he's going to seize the moment come January 19th.
Adrien, I know you're focused on the task at hand, and that's Manny Pacquiao, but reflecting back on your fight with Mikey Garcia, how would you
fight? I ain't fighting Mikey, brother. I ain't fighting Mikey.
What is your assessment on his fight with
him? I ain't fighting Mikey. I ain't worried about Mikey.
We're not here to talk about Mikey and Earl.
You know, I'm Mikey.
Hey, Adrien. Who is Adrien the Problem Broner right now in the boxing world, and who is he December or January 19th, the night of after the fight, if he wins? In the boxing world?
Adrien, the problem, bro.
But who are you? Are you more...
I'm me, bro.
Okay.
I'm me. Everywhere. Right. It's your first time, I know.
Okay. I'm trying. I'm just in college.
Hey, what's your biggest advantage, you think, in this fight, Adrien?
Y'all gonna understand me. Y'all gonna understand me more. Y'all gonna understand me more. He really can't talk that good of English.
I think his youth. I think the fact that he's in the prime of
his
career.
You're funny, dude.
I think that's a big advantage for him, a huge advantage. You know, Manny's not fighting some guy who's not slick, who can't punch. He's fighting a guy who's in the prime of his career, and he knows what he got to do.
You're a tough interview, AV. It's rough. We enjoy your fights. We enjoy seeing you outside the ring, the positive, the good, the bad, because overall you bring attention to the sport. How would you like us to work with you? It's rough when we get together with you.
It really ain't rough. It's just y'all make it rough on yourself. Y'all ask difficult questions. Y'all just got to ask the right stuff.
How will you win this fight?
Huh?
How will you win this fight?
One more time.
How will you win this fight?
Just be myself, stay focused, you know, it's all about preparation, man. As long as we do what we gotta do in the gym, Coach Kevin Cunningham and Coach Mike Stafford, you know, and my brother's right on the side of me pushing me to the limit, everything's gonna be all right. January 19th is gonna be a hell of a night, man.
We'll take a couple more questions. Anybody else?
Adrien, everyone seems to have a story. Everyone has a story. We've all been through something, overcome something that sort of allowed us to become where we are today. What would you say that one thing was for you that really kind of brought you to where you are today as a man?
I really can't say. You know, I still got cases pending.
All right, with that.
I'm just saying, I think when all of this is done, you should really transition into comedy. Like you do stand-up pros. Because when you're on stage, like walking around, you're pretty natural at doing it.
Thanks.
No, you're just the clap back king. Like you just sort of have the right thing to say after everyone asks.
Well, speaking of funny, 50 Cent posted, if you lose, you fuck up his money.
He got money? I mean,
there you go, the clap back king. There you go. He's betting on you, he said, basically.
No, 50 Cent, though, that's the homeboy. Okay. Yeah,
can I get a rebound question?
Come on, go ahead. I'll give you one.
Okay. So you were a kid watching boxers, and you wanted to be in that situation of being a professional. What do you say to those kids now that don't have hope of being there?
Just stay focused. No matter if your dream is being an artist or mechanic, you know, just stay focused and don't let nobody tell you you can't do nothing.
Thank you.
All right. Well, nice rebound. Well, all right, that's it.